Reincarnation of the Strongest Sword God. Written by Lucky Old Cat. Chapter 345 Storm Domain. Look, there's a monster over there. It's massive. Wait. Why does a level 50 High Lord possess 40 million HP? This is the most powerful High Lord I've ever seen. I wonder what items it will drop after it dies. At the very least, it should drop some fine gold items, right? Are all of you blind? That mutant High Lord is clearly stronger than ordinary High Lords. If a High Lord already drops fine gold items, then a mutant High Lord, which is a higher rank, should drop dark gold items. Dark gold items. There should only be a few items of such rank in Star Moon Kingdom, right? At this moment, the many players in White River City had started to gather at the teleportation hall. A sea of players covered the nearby streets, all of them watching the Mechanical Slayer with hungry gazes. These players considered the Mechanical Slayer to be a field boss that could be easily killed. Meanwhile, among the sea of players, there was actually not a single Zero Wing member to be found. Shurfeng had long since informed his guild that they were not allowed to participate in this battle. Shurfeng's reason was not due to lack of interest in the loot of the Mechanical Slayer. Instead, he understood that they would only throw away their lives by joining this battle. Guild leader Tyrant, our men have arrived. Good. The Mechanical Slayer belongs to us. Tell everyone to spread out and take positions. None of the melees are allowed to approach the Mechanical Slayer. Ranged players should distance themselves from the Mechanical Slayer and attack from maximum range. Let the other players draw the aggro and die for us. As for the melee players, have them aim for Black Flame. We must not let him escape. Although Lone Tyrant was shocked by how powerful the Mechanical Slayer was, such a powerful monster also represented a ridiculous amount of valuable loot. Despite the fact that Dark Star only had several thousand members present, its main army was on its way. In addition to the other guilds and independent players of White River City, the final number of players they could gather would exceed 200,000. Currently, if the players present attacked the Mechanical Slayer, most of their attacks would either deal one damage or miss. Even so, this Mechanical Slayer with 40 million HP would not survive for long under the continuous assault of 200,000 players. Moreover, there weren't just 100 or so guards in White River City. In time, the city would send more guards into the fray. In a way, the Mechanical Slayer's death was a guarantee. It was only a matter of who would obtain the loot of the Mechanical Slayer after it died. At the same time Dark Star took action, the other guilds also initiated their assault. After witnessing the power of the Mechanical Slayer, only ranged players dared to attack it. As for those remaining, they all swarmed after Shurfeng. Only those who had just arrived and were unclear of the situation dared approach the frightening Mechanical Slayer. That Lone Tyrant sure is concerned about me. Even now, he still sends so many after me. Standing on top of a roof, Shurfeng had obtained a clear view of the battle. Since they wish to come, let's increase the violence. Immediately, Shurfeng dashed towards Dark Star's army. Although countless spells and arrows barraged the Mechanical Slayer, a majority of these attacks were a miss, and only a small number managed to deal a mandatory one damage. Hence, Shurfeng was still the Slayer's main target. Due to the large number of players standing in between it and Shurfeng, the Mechanical Slayer wielded its sword, massacring everything in its path. Every time the Mechanical Slayer swung its serrated greatsword, swaths of players died. This scene caused the witnessing players to shiver in fear. However, it was precisely because of these players that the Mechanical Slayer's speed was greatly reduced, allowing Shurfeng to have an easier time dodging. Meanwhile, when the members of Dark Star saw that Shurfeng quickly approached them, ridiculing sneers started appearing on their faces. This black flame must have damaged his head. Instead of running away from us, he actually dares to run in our direction. Is he that eager to die? Isn't that better? He's saving us the time of chasing after him. However, just as the members of Dark Star mocked Shurfeng for his stupidity, Lone Tyrant angrily bellowed in the guild channel. You bunch of trash. Run. Get away from Black Flame. Don't let him come close to any of you. The command confused Lone Tyrant's subordinates. Initially, Lone Tyrant had commanded them to surround Shurfong, yet now he told them to run as soon as they saw Shurfong. However, Lone Tyrant's reminder was useless. Shurfong had already arrived before the members of Dark Star. Meanwhile, the Mechanical Slayer's greatsword descended towards Shurfong. Using silent steps, Shurfong reappeared beside a player 20 yards from his original position, deftly avoiding the mutant's fatal strike. After a series of dodges, almost 90% of the thousands of Dark Star members who had encircled Shurfong died, and only a few with dazed expressions remained. Lone Tyrant trembled in anger. Thousands of members had died, just like that. Lone Tyrant was greatly confused. He could not understand why the Mechanical Slayer so vehemently chased Shurfong. Just what had Shurfong done to it before this? Right now, with Shurfang's high-speed movements, it was simply impossible for any ranged players to land an attack on him. Yet, if the melee players approached Shurfong, the shockwaves of the Slayer's attacks would slaughter them. With the Mechanical Slayer's aggro locked on to Shurfong, he was practically a walking bomb. However, Lone Tyrant could not stop Shurfong. Even with so many players, none of them could pin down Shurfong. If someone could have pinned him down for just a moment, Shurfong would have long since died. At this moment, Lone Tyrant finally realized the great importance of top-tier experts to a guild. Even if he had an army of thousands, the role they could play in this sort of battle was far inferior to top-tier experts. Damn Black Flame. Lone Tyrant cursed loudly as he watched his guild members die in waves. At this moment, Lone Tyrant no longer looked like the guild leader of a powerful guild. Instead, he looked more like a shrew, shouting abuse on the street. Lone Tyrant's performance left witnesses stupefied. It turned out that even the guild leader of Darkstar had such a side to him. One could just imagine how helpless and infuriated Lone Tyrant felt at this moment. As for the other guild leaders watching this at this moment, rather than expressing ridicule, they all wore gloomy expressions. Their guilds were in the same boat as Darkstar. After Shurfong finished dealing with Darkstar, he would certainly turn his blade in their directions. So, how could they possibly feel happy over Lone Tyrant's miserable fortune? Why don't we admit our mistakes and apologize to guild leader Black Flame? Are you kidding me? If all of our guilds lower our heads to Zero Wing, how are we supposed to succeed in White River City in the future? But, if we don't apologize, what will we do if he retaliates against us? Wait, look over there. More guards have shown up. While the guards deal with the Mechanical Slayer, we can work together to get rid of Black Flame. With so many on our side, Black Flame can't survive regardless of how powerful he may be. As long as he dies, Zero Wing will lose its momentum in becoming the overlord of White River City. At that time, we might still be able to thrive. Watching the hundreds of guards who had already surrounded the Mechanical Slayer, the guild leaders of the various large guilds agreed with the logic. Black Flame's death would be a huge blow to Zero Wing's prestige. If unrated guilds like them wished to thrive, they could not allow a single guild to obtain an absolute advantage in White River City. Currently, Zero Wing was like the sun at noon. If they allowed the guild to continue sooner or later, they would stand no chance against Zero Wing at all. Hence, the various guild leaders instructed their members to focus all of their strength on killing Shurfong. Shurfong wrinkled his sharp brows when he saw the NPC guards charge at the Mechanical Slayer and the various guilds who took action. Knowing that his situation had become unstable, Shurfong spun around and started running towards the Mechanical Slayer, no longer charging towards the members of the various guilds. Within a moment, everyone from the various guilds had surrounded both Shurfong and the Mechanical Slayer. However, these guild players had finally wisened up. Instead of recklessly rushing forward to attack Shurfong, they allowed the ranged players to attack him as they slowly tightened their circle around him, forcing Shurfong into a constant retreat. Just as Shurfong was about to enter the Mechanical Slayer's attack range of 30 yards, the Mechanical Slayer's HP fell to 80%. Suddenly, its eyes shone a bright red, and clasping its greatsword with both hands, the mutant slammed the weapon into the ground. Naturally, Shurfong understood what the Mechanical Slayer intended to do. This was none other than the Mechanical Slayer's ultimate move, Storm Domain. The skill had a radius of over 100 yards, and even his level 50 tier 1 guards had died from a single hit. Back then, if Shurfong had not used Wind Rider, his speed skyrocketing, the consequences would have been unimaginable. At this moment, Shurfong immediately switched to the Seven Luminaries Ring's Aura of Illusion, activating Fantasy World.